The future is now. Your maximum point of power is... Oh, wait. Take two. The past is a canceled check. Your maximum point of power is now.
Beck Hansen, the perpetually adolescent singer, songwriter, and philosopher, has just released his critically acclaimed second major label album.
Orale. Orale. It's orderly.
Orderly, 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 orderly.
It's a certain celebratory aspect to it, but right now, actually, the seafaring aspect is more the theme of the tour that we're embarking on now as a voyage.
The voyage begins.
Beck's own voyage set sail in the early 90s, playing coffee houses and other small venues, even local parks in his Los Angeles community, where the singer began fusing his influences from guitar-based folk.
Tonight the city is full of morgues.
We took up with acoustic guitars, and we found ourselves beating these things, these crude, stringed, wooden things.
To slightly less crude electronic things, loop-driven sample-based hip-hop tracks that form the foundation of many of Beck's songs.
We gazed upon this machine with envy and rage. We touched the buttons, and they were tender yet forceful. And then the beats came forth, surged like a wave. And on that crest, our rhythm was born.
Explains a lot, man.
To help unify his complex palette of sounds, Beck signed on the Dust Brothers of Beastie Boys' Paul's Boutique fame to produce Odelay. But for Beck, the songs don't really take shape until he shares them with a live audience.
It's strange being in the studio for months and months and constructing these songs and bringing them to life. The songs aren't really done until they're performed, you know. Sometimes they start as a little skiff, and eventually they graduate to an ocean liner. A lot of songs that I just write with a guitar. I've been doing that for years, and with Mel Gold and this new album, this is really just an extension of that, going into the studio and just laying stuff down and seeing what happens.
What happened on 1993's Mellow Gold, Beck's first album, was the tidal wave-like success of an anthemic track called Loser that in one fell swoop thrust Beck onto the musical map and, to his dismay, the cultural one as well.
It was frustrating, the song being taken out of context and being used as this Generation X thing, which I could see it totally fitting, but it wasn't really intended as that, and it made me a little sad that this song, you know, could be used as something to sum up a whole generation.
I'm a loser, baby, so why don't you kill me?
I'm a little wary of anthems, but it's cool to play it now because it's funny. I feel like I'm doing a cover, so it really has a karaoke aspect doing the song now.
While Loser may be a karaoke favorite, Where It's At, Beck's Buzz Clip video, looks like it may become a line dance hit at your local country roadhouse, which Beck endorses with caution.
I don't mind. I encourage it, actually. Although there is a danger in organized dancing. Caution is the word. You know, line dancing already organized, regimented dancing activity.
Wait, I'm getting a call. Hello?
Beck will definitely be staying active in the future. He's got a new single, Devil's Haircut, set to be released.
Got a devil's haircut in my mind. Got a devil's haircut in my mind.
And a full tour scheduled through the fall. Beyond that is a tough forecast.
Storm clouds on the rise. We will march. We will sail headlong and headstrong and headless, if needs be, towards that destination. All right.